natin na Seiya, yung game number one natin, Black Pearl versus NXP. And nakikita naman natin sa kaliwa, on the blue side, yung mga pangalan na kilalang kilala talaga natin, sila MD, sila Sagitnu, sila Yolo, sila Goddess, pati na rin si Yuji. Actually, si Yuji talaga na miss ko na mapanood, maglaro. So, medyo excited ako, no, kung ano ipapakita ng mga players natin dito on the next place. Sorry, pero excited din ako sa ipapakita ng mga players natin on the red side kung makakasabay ba sila sa NXP or kailangan na bang bigyan ng Vivo V21 para makapagsabay talaga against next play Vivo.
Secure nga ni Goddess itong kanyang buff and a very good time na to gank right now. Midnight, tignan mo, it's a 3 versus 2 fight. Si Helix very low on HP. That's gonna be the first blood na sa ating Matilda ngayon.
So the support Matilda is gonna be a big problem here for Black Pearl.
Yeah, so basically it's just a shift of role for the side of Matilda, not maybe affecting it in terms of a burst. Ooh. But right now, looking here on
the naman is that they have a Ling, and si Ling usually kapag nawawala ng purple buffet, hindi naging snowball, napadali i-shut down. Pero the opposite is actually happening here, no? Si Goddess ay nakakakuha na ng 3 kills for his team. Even though hindi siya nakakakuha, this still allows him to snowball in the game.
True. And looking at this, nabagit nga natin kanina, yung lineup ng Black Pearl is supposed to be for picking offs. But right now, the rotation coming in from next play, hindi na sila naghihiwalay dito. And that's going to be a pick-off coming in from the bottom, transitioning into the jungle side here. Tenbay pumasok ni Kelsey with the ult coming in, but hindi masyadong kukonek dito because the call coming in from Yuji and Yolo was actually pretty good.
Para pagdating ng mid-game, hindi solo buhat si Goddess. May insane team fight presence sila with the export per Goddess. Uy! Actually, sa payong napatay dito, trying to take the veil down.
Positioning into the rotation hanggang sa they just wait for the objective to spawn, and that's gonna be turtle secured. Plus, the Franco Helix muli ay mawawala sa ating mapa.
System of teamfights.
Goddess going in towards Veil first kasi alam niyo isa siya sa mga threat dito, and with the dragon as well, that is a separate fight but still with the main cause here, I mean main goal is to take down. Pero na-shot on dito si Goddess into that turret dive, and it is at least a consolation para sa side ng Black Pearl dito.
Ano dito ni MB on the Xborg, War Axe into Immortality, yung nagiging staple build on the Xborg, pero mid lane teamfight.
Grabe, Way of the Dragon right there.
Hindi pa nabubuo ni Roger yung second item niya, no? Even though meron na siyang War Axe dito. Oh, top lane.
Oh, okay. That was a very good combo coming in. Matilda will be getting the kill. Pero dito, unfortunately, hindi sapat ang lifesteal ng ating Alice to actually take them down. But the numbers, napaka-advantageous talaga sa ating next pet. Nagkukumpula na sila. And hindi
talaga... Red team to come back. Yung resource na lang kasi talaga yung kinokontrol ng next pet dito. Oy! Ganda naman
nun! Na-hook si Yolo doon. And that's gonna be a casualty. But the last insanity is gonna give a lot of damage dito. And that's gonna be an entry for the Matilda as well. Yuji here really doing a pretty good job. Mukhang support killer talaga si Yuji dito. Oh, but look at this Goddess. Hindi rin siya papatalo para sa kanya. And that's gonna be another casualty as well, making it a double kill. Naku, mukhang magwa-wipe out pa sila dito, ha. And Dr. Natsu is only forced to just stay in his turf, but I don't think it's enough to actually defend this. Crackle's already gonna spawn, but the hook flicker did not work. Walang nahuli.
Yeah. NXP, they're gonna disengage back away from the base of Black Pearl kasi wala silang minion wave in the middle lane. Top lane, however, it's a different story. There's a minion wave marching in the base of Black Pearl. Baka ito na yung hinaharap na push ng next play. And I feel like MB is, you know, really, really looking forward to the next last insanity team fight inside the base of Black Pearl kasi napaka-massive talaga ng teamfight presence ng hero na to.
And ayan, may attempt ulit ang ating team next play dito, no? But that's gonna be an ejector.
Ooh, MB!
But look at this, MB though! That was a beautiful entry for the Kagura to burst them out. So, inuuna nila tong turret na to, but the Roger will be able to take down the Kagura here, only to be avenged by Goddess. Sa gitna na nakukuha ng turret, pero hindi. Yan, sabit pero makuhook si Yolo dito ni Arrowhead.
Ooh,
but that
minion
is not enough, but there's no minions anymore. Ayun. The base, ayan na, mukhang mababasag na. Dr. Natsu is trying his best to actually protect, but with a lot of numbers coming in from next play dito.
Oh, he's doing it.
Uy, but it's doing it again. Jawhead one more time. Going in. Look at that damage. Oh, and the burst. But next play, Vivo is gonna come out triumphant.
Yeah. Speaking of nagiinit na damdamin, di pa tapos yung usapan natin. Game number 2 na kagad. Madaling-madali yung team nakalaban ng next play ngayon. This is Team Noxus versus Team Next Play. Again, NXP is on the blue side and Team Noxus is on the red side. Dalawa yung Yasuo, no? Magkaiba lang na spelling. Yasu and Yasu. So, mahirap yung shoutcast, no? Pinapahirapan pa talaga tayo. Mga community members natin. Pero okay lang. Kakayanin natin yan dahil tayo ay naka-vivo. Yung ibang grand player usually nag-aabang lang ano yan, nag-aabang lang ng ampasin. Si Yoro talaga lalakarin niya, papakita niya lagi rito. No. Sige, kalimutin mo to. Kalimutin mo yung bato. Ang mahirap kalimutin kasi yung bato. Masisira daliri mo dyan. Pero ito si Glue. MB, pumasok na kay Roger pero he's forced to flicker out the damage. Is actually very very high on the side of Noxus pero sabi ni Goddess objective lang 30 lang ang gusto ko.
Yes, but looking at this, Yasuo was able to get the first blood coming in, taking down MB. But that's gonna be a trade coming in from the Harley. Si Yuji dito makakuha na isa. And of course, hindi rin magpapatalo si Sagitt no, taking
Goddess
down another. But Goddess here, tinatry niyang kunin si Marso dito na nagta-tower hug sa ating top side. Ayaw pa uwiin, pero tignan natin kung mara-respond, diba, ang ibang members ng NXP. Si Yasuo ay nandito na rin. But look at this, Yuji sa ating backlines with that stealth move. Nakuha pa rin si Marso.
I think kung mag-iibang bias story dito. As YOLO takes down the Kufra. Actually, si Saber Kumo na kill. And the Ling will be able to use the Tempest Blades. Chase down the heroes of Team Noxus. Stacking up the tower damage. And they find four heroes in the middle lane to secure in an objective here for Team Next.
So this is getting a bit nakikita natin yung lamang ngayon ng NXP, but then there's gonna be another fight here into the turtle side. Mukhang napadaan lang si Pakito tapos binati siya ng apat ng next play at ayun, napapasok na muli ang ating Grok dito, and of course with the other members of next play, at hindi talaga nila hinayaan makatakas ang kahit isang member ng Noxus, at hindi pa nagtatapos doon si Envy. No,
bawal talaga mo eh. Bawal ang mo ulan kasi ano, hampas.
Diba? Focus na lang on farming itong Roger kasi hindi talaga sila makapasok kaagad eh. And kailangan maghintay talaga ni Marso ng timing. Pero speaking of timing, napakagandang timing talaga ni Harley doon. Taking down si 40X at mukhang in-avenge niya si Sagitt na doon. At ult coming in from the Saber here. Walang hesitations into that tower dive. And again, for the side of Harley dito kay Yuji. Talagang pasok lang siya ng pasok. Napaka-confident eh. Lalo na kapag alam mong meron ka ng burst, yun doon na talaga ikaw mag-shine. So, bouncing ball dito for the Kufra. Mag-1v1 talaga dito na YOLO. Pero syempre si YOLO, doon muna sa tore. Ano, pag nakakuha ka talaga ng objectives na uncontested and with all of these skills. And speaking of kills, ayan na naman, mukhang binati ko. As we do see Sagitt no taking down one. That was a beautiful ult coming in from MB right there. And actually Grok YOLO rather. And patuloy-tuloy na. That knockup was more than enough to actually crowd control the members of Noxus here para makakuha ng magandang kills itong si Yuji. And yun, naharangan si Kuya Mumarso at papasok ang ating Mugades, and with the Templates of Blaze, ayan na, that's gonna be another pickup coming in from the Ling, and with the easy disengagement coming in para sa ating Goddess.
The pass from the Nexus Warlord, unfortunately, hindi tumama sa pader yung kanyang ultimate dito onto the Glue and the Harley. Goddess, can he take down the Eudora? Yes, he will be able to do so, and that is gonna be 3 kills going in favor of next play without any trade coming out from Team Noxus. Maganda sana right here, right now, 40X will be able to use the ultimate to clear some minion wave, pero hindi enough yung kanyang damage to take out the entire wave in the middle lane. And look at the damage output again from the Harley. Napakataas nung damage from the cards. Even Sagitt with the Shuriken and Lexis Warlock, siya na lang inatira, and that will be a complete wipeout in favor of next play. Ending the game faster than game number 1. 10-41 this time around, ladies and gentlemen.
With 20.07 KDA for the side of Yuji. Grabe talaga, napaka ML na ML itong si kuya nating Yuji.
Saya, game number 3, next play versus Superiors, ang team na mahirap banggitin ang pangalan sa shoutcast. Sila High Minds, Queen Savage, Dos Noel 2496, Kiss Lies, Extraterrestrial, at pati na rin si di ba ako nabanggit? Actually, nabanggit ko na pa lahat. Anin pala yung dapat nabanggitin ko. Anin pala dapat nababanggitin ko. Andaya naman yun, 6v5. Turtle. Nasa turtle lagi, pero to, dash in. Meron siyang shadows dito to get away, pero nagpo-posting siya ng threat against the heroes of Superiors. Actually, ang ganda nito, sinasabayan siya ni nung kanyang kampe para hindi lang siya yung hindi lang siya yung mag-tank ng tower damage. Actually, that was MB on the Benedetta and Goddess. gonna be able to get out of there and take another kill. Maybe enough ba? Hindi. Actually, hindi. Mabubuhay pa rin si Hyman. So, Roger is still able to get out.
GU members ng ating next play dito, whenever he tries to go for that push. But right now, kung naipit siya ng tatlo dito, being knocked up by the
corner
here. Pero look at that!
Oh,
MVP
with
an insanity and order of brilliance dito. Magagaling kay ate mo, Yuji, dito. And right now, on the backlines, Goddess though, hindi siya papatala as well with Benedetta getting that double kill. And that was a four-man down midnight.
Anong full combo ng superiors, pero after that, that was it. NXP knew na ito lang yung teamfight ng superiors.
Yes, and look at this. After the turtle take, diretso kay Guinevere. So technically, kulang na naman ulit ang members of Superior dito. Sa Gitno really doing a good job as a distraction here while si Goddess na try nilang breach itong ating top side. The third Kadita here going in. That's gonna be a knockout for three members ng ating Superior. And look at this beautiful save with the Order of Brilliance plus yung overall damage coming in from next play is enough to give UG a double kill. So
for next play, pero fortunately for Superiors, yung mid lane minion wave ay magmi-meet pala.
Mm-hmm. And kita mo naman din, hindi na lalayo masyado si Goddess sa turtle side nga banggit mo, ano, lagi siyang present. But look at that beautiful knock-up coming in, plus the ult coming from the Guinevere as well. That's to be a shutdown and going in for double kill Kadita as well. Masyado si Yolo to hindi abot ang kanyang respo. Last insanity, di ka ating Benedetta. Si MB, is it going to be a maniac? Indeed, at mahahunting si Queen Savage dito, but really not enough for the distance and the turnaround coming in from MB dito. Mukhang gigil si Kuya mo, MB.
It's looking like NXP have the upper hand kasi sila again yung late game lineup in this game and sila yung leading in the mid game.
Into the bottom side we go. That was a beautiful knock-up by the Paquito Goddess for the clean-up. So, gaya nga na nang bagit mo, no? Masyado nang napupush back ang members ng Superiors dito, not having that much of a control over the map. Ooh, that was an unfortunate push rather coming in from Kisslice there and is forced to disengage as well. Pero mukhang minamata siya ni Goddess dito going in towards that shadow. Oh, but the clean-up is still gonna go for UG back there. So,
in front of the middle lane tower ng Superiors dito, last insanity used by the X-Boy. Pero look at the damage output from NXP with the Benedetta using the Electro Final Blow. The wipe is gonna come for NXP. Four heroes down on the side of Superiors in just a blink of an eye. Four heroes fall on the side of Superiors. Although hindi nila natapatan yung record, it's close enough. NXP closes out game number 3 on the back of MB's performance on the Benedetta.